Pitch black. Rats trying to eat you alive. And the box I was in couldn't have been much bigger than a cubicle in the gents.
So could you literally not see anything?
Nothing. Total sensory deprivation. You lose all sense of time. You hallucinate. You hear things. You get paranoid. Your brain efficiency decreases.
Yeah, then you come home and join the old bill.
You might laugh, Paul. But 1 week in the notorious boxes of the KNC's Mao Ying Marriott is enough to destroy the mind of any man.
So how long were you in there for, then, Tim?
A year. 460, please.
So gentle, then anxious son.
How come you never cracked up then, Tim?
Oh, I did. At first. It's what you do afterwards that counts. Relive old memories. Places you've lived. Films, friends. Some people just sit there and keep counting to a million. Takes 3 weeks, by the way. 8 hours a day.
You see, that is why I'd be all right.
Well, because you can count.
No, I'd be all right, Sean, because I'm a thinker. I'm mentally strong. I've got what they call a rich internal dialogue.
Shut up.
I'd last longer than you would.
No way.
Oh, what, remember Camber Sands? 3 minutes I left you locked in the van. When I come back with the ice creams, you'd smashed up.
Well, it was hot, wasn't it?
Oh, right, not like the cool of the Yankesh Delta. What was it in them boxes, Tim?
A Red Cross gauged it at 130 Fahrenheit. But that was before sunrise.
You out on the pool table, Sean?
Cheers. See you in a minute.
Hello.
Ciao, Paolo, come stai?
La mia mamma da giri per tutti la marinai.
Your friends are waiting for you over there.
Love, friends? Oh, bollocks, not again.
All over the nun. Why, the bloke who's dressed as a monk, he's still behind this donkey, right? His habit's wide open and he's pumping away like a fireman, right? They don't show you that on you being framed.
Hello, Tamsin. Might I just say you look bellissimo tonight?
Bellissimo? You prat, Paul.
Anyway, sorry I'm a bit late. Have you had a nice day?
Yeah. Until he showed up.
Here, Paul, do you remember that stripper at Jasper Stag Night? She was called Madame Bellissimo, wasn't she?
Yeah, but I don't think that's quite a story.
Should have seen his face, Tasman.
Tamsin.
Yeah, whatever, anyway, right? She's come up to him with his dildo, literally the size of a roll of carpet, right?
Sure.
How she's got this thing on stage, without a winch, I'll never know, right? She swung this thing round. He's like that.
That is it.
Tamsin, what are you doing? Tamsin, wait.
Oh, thank you, Sean, mate, thanks. That's all right, Paul. I think I've laid the groundwork for you there, mate.
Oh, piss off. Tamsin, wait.
No, Paul. 3 times he's shown up now. Makes me wonder if you're a couple of perverts or something playing a sick game with me.
Oh, don't be stupid.
Well, how come he follows you everywhere?
He's my security. Yeah, I have to have close protection.
Why does he always arrive 10 minutes before you do, then?
Well, he has to check the place out, doesn't he? Assess it for risk. Look, I know he's a bit of a rough diamond.
A bit? Before you arrived, he was talking about animal films.
Animal films?
Yes.
Look, you know how much you mean to me. I swear I can make this up to you.
How?
I'll take you somewhere really special.
Where?
We'll go away to the country. We'll get away.
It better be some kind of 5-star hotel. Because that's what it'll take to make up for tonight, I tell you.
Strike three, Paul. You must be losing your touch.
Losing my touch? I ain't had a chance to use it, have I, with you showing up? What are you doing here anyway?
Hook, line and sinker, mate. I give you this oath, Paul. You nearly done me this time. I mean, if Shiv hadn't have told me, I never would have found this place. Never would have been game over, mate.
Short, this is not a game. It's my life, and you're ruining it.
You're just a bit niggly because you ain't eating. Now, come on, there's a table for two in there.
How can I put this? Okay. If I had a choice between sitting there at a table with you, yeah, or being locked up in one of the boxes of the Miao Ying Marriott with Tim and the boys, I'd be on a jet plane to Yankesh now. Yeah? Now piss off and leave me alone.
Oh, come on, Mo, what are you messing about?
Piss off.
Paul! I've ordered the Oso Bucci over two persons.
Is that a room with a four-poster? What, breakfast is included? OK. Yeah, how much is that? $225? No, that sounds very reasonable. Yeah. Yeah, I'll get back to you about that.
Not that price you wear.
No, that was just my secretary. Yeah, she thinks she's funny. Yeah, you're fired, Alison. Get your cards and go, please. Yeah, I'll get back to you. OK, bye.
I don't know why you bother, Paul. You ain't going to be able to afford it.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't have to bother, would I? He hadn't told Sean where I was.
Well, he was desperate, Paul. He said it was an emergency.
He was winding you up, Schiff. You know, it's like a game to him, turning up on my dates.
I'll get it.
Mm. Well, it all sounds a bit gay to me. Like you're lovers or something.
Lovers? Schiff, we've known each other since we was 4 years old. Lovers.
All right, Paul. Listen, about last night. I'm really sorry, yeah?
Sean, can I just have a word, please?
What's the matter?
Listen, Sean, I think we need a bit of time apart, mate, yeah? Because at the moment, I feel like I'm living my whole life with you leaning over my shoulder, you know? When people start thinking we're lovers or something.
Oh, right. So that means you won't want to come away with me this weekend to me Uncle Ronnie's gaff, doesn't it?
Sean, you're not listening to me, mate. What, the big gaff up near Box Hill?
Yeah, he's gone away and he wants me to look after the place.
With the swimming pool and a four-poster bed and a beautiful landscape gardens.
Yeah, come down here with me, Paul. It'd be brilliant.
No, I'm going away with Tamsin this weekend. That's it.
Tricky, very tricky. I've got it. You and Tasmin can have the place to yourself for any 24 hours you want.
No. I know you. You'll turn up. You'll pretend to be a local rat catcher or something.
Oh, I won't. I swear to God, man, I'll never move on my eyesight, right? For 24 hours, it will be a Sean-free zone.
No, I can't risk it. I just can't risk it, Sean.
Well, it won't cost you nothing. Not a penny, mate.
Come here.
Let go, Sean. Let go, let go, let go, let go.
What's the matter? Nothing. Just let go, let go. Right, we're all set then. Yes, one of my business partners has been living there for a month since his divorce, but he's gone to the States, so we've got the place to ourselves.
Well, I can't Saturday, because I've got to work.
About Sunday?
Going to my parents for lunch in Guildford. Oh. I haven't seen him for ages.
Listen, I got it right. Box Hill's only round the corner. Come over for lunch, bring them along, I'll do a barbecue. I've got to meet him sometime. Then, if you want to, you can always stay on after.
Could do, I suppose. I have got the day off Monday.
Yeah? Everything you need is down here. Address, phone number, shoe size.
You're going to be there on your own, yeah? He's not going to be there, is he? That pervert mate of yours who follows you everywhere. You promise he's not going
to
be there?
Don't worry about it. He's had to go to Russia. Yeah, one of our employees has been kidnapped. Right, 12:30 Sunday, you're gonna be there, yeah? Okay. Oh, Tamsin, don't forget your bikini. Sure.
Yeah, it's round here somewhere.
Well, it should be any second now.
Yeah, it's right on us. Anywhere, somewhere around here.
Well, look at the map. It's Canby Island. You're not even on the right page.
That's it there, look.
Here we go.
There it is, look, there. Do a left here.
Lusty Grange.
That's it, go on.
I know, Sean, I'm doing it.
Just go right down to the bottom, yeah?
Yeah, I know. Sean, we're here.
Right the way down. Just pull right round outside.
I know. Oh, roll on Sunday, because Tamsin is going to love this, mate.
Now, most of the upstairs rooms is locked, and all the outbuildings are covered by the general alarm.
Okay, now do you have all the colours?
Look at Lupo. He's got his lipstick out. Look. Dirty, great, lovely red crayon on the booker. Astral too, and Barra. Now you just stop flirting with this young man, you little tarts. Where was we?
Codes?
Keys and codes. I'll just get them for you.
So, bit familiar with the old dogs, isn't she?
Oh, yeah, legendary for it. My cousin Sean, spelled S-H, yeah? One day, he's walked in the laundry room, he reckons, right, he caught her.
What do you mean, caught her?
You know, with the dogs.
Oh, Sean, that is disgusting. How can you think of something like that?
It's true, Paul, I'm telling you, I'm not lying, I mean it. It's
here you are. Keys and codes, and this is the attack command for them three lovelies.
Very nice. Like it.
What is it?
Can't tell you, I'm afraid. Need to know, innit?
Well, how come you need to know and I don't?
Because you ain't comfortable around dogs, Paul. They smell your fear.
No, no, that is not true. You know, I love dogs. You remember Sandy?
Yeah, he was a collie.
So?
Well, they never made Lassie with Rottweiler, did they, Paul?
No, you're wrong about that, mate. Sandy could go a bit.
The only place he went was under your dad's lorry, mate.
That is low, Sean. Very low. Shiv still cries about that.
How can you two? Is he your lover or something?
No. No, we're just mates, you know.
Well, whatever you are, lovers, friends, I don't want neither of you messing with that attack command. Because once those three go, it's like opening the gates of hell. Is that clear?
Crystal, Mrs. P. I've spent 15 years working with attack dogs.
You?
Oh, yes, Mrs. Pedley.
Right. I'll drop by Sunday morning. Behave yourselves.
Right then, Sean. I think the weekend starts here.
Handsome.
It's the good life, full of fun, seems to be the ideal. Yes, the good life lets you hide all the sadness you feel. You won't really fall in love, for you can't take the chance.
80, 90,
so be honest
20.
With yourself. Don't try to fake romance. Well, just wake up, kiss the good life goodbye.
HMS Victory.
You're saying HMS Victory?
Yes.
Is that your final answer?
Yes.
You're absolutely sure about that?
Yes.
I ask you for the name of the ship on which Admiral Lord Horatio Nelson died at the Battle of Trafalgar. You said HMS Victory. Paul, you have won a plastic cheese.
You'll go. Right, entertainment. Before I ask you this annoyingly easy question, I just want to make one thing clear, yeah? This is not Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, yeah? It is Trivial Pursuit. Is that clear?
Okay,
let's just speed it up a bit. We've had four questions in the last hour.
I'm sorry.
What is the name of the 1970 film reconstructing the events on both sides leading to the Japanese attack on Pearl Harbor?
I've still got three lifelines. Sorry, okay. But I think I'm going to have to go with my gut feeling on this one, Chris. Paul. Tora. Yes!
Maybe I shouldn't have said that, actually.
What?
Tora. What are you whispering for?
It's the attack command for the dogs, isn't it?
Oh, that's the attack command, is it? Tora, Tora, Tora. What, I can't say Tora, Tora, Tora?
Now you're being silly, Paul.
Oh, come on, Sean. There is no way they can hear us from here. Oh, dear. All out of champagne. Still, plenty more where that came from, eh? There, Sean. Tora, Tora, Tora. Peddling? Sean. Sean, the dogs have gone into attack mode.
Oh, really? Well, I hate to say I told you so, Paul.
What are we going
to
do?
Oh, right. So now you want to know about attack dogs, yeah?
I think they've gone away.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Why's that then? Because they know we're friendly?
No. It's because they know they ain't getting through there.
There's a light switch.
Outside.
Oh, brilliant. Well, how long are they going to be out there for?
Until someone calls them off or they rip us to pieces.
Where are we anyway?
Shell top toilet bowl from the alchemy range. Gravity fed mixer shower with adjustable free spray head. Beautiful.
Ow!
Windsor towel rail, chrome taps. All in all, a very tasteful shower room, Paul.
Oh, this is bad, Sean. This is really bad, mate. Things can't get worse than this, I tell you.
They can, actually, Paul.
Oh, yeah? How, Sean? We're stuck in a shower room with no light, food, or means of communication. There's three Rottweilers outside waiting to, quote, rip us to pieces. Rip us to pieces. And Tamsin gets here in 36 hours. So you tell me, Sean, how can things get worse?
I need a shit.
Oh, Sean, that is disgusting.
It's only like you smell of roses, is it, Paul? Lurethane, Brady's, Sterling.
Oh! What are you doing?
Checking the cupboard for supplies.
Oh, what, is there some bacon in there? A couple of steaks, nice cold lager?
Well, another one. You just had a bottle of pills.
What?
On your head, you prick. Bottle of pills fell out the cupboard.
Yeah, very fun. I'm glad you can joke about it, mate.
Got to, Paul. Otherwise, we'd go mad. It's like what Tim was talking about, sensory deprivation. Thinking about it, maybe we should do a few memory exercises. Sing some songs, wrestle.
Don't be stupid, Sean. You can hardly compare solitary confinement in one of the Miao Ying Marriott's notorious boxes with being trapped in a shower room in a mansion in Box Hill. Sensory deprivation, come on.
Suit yourself. One, two, three, four, five.
Oh, come on, Sean, you are not seriously going to count to a million.
8, 6,007, 6,008, 6,009, 6,010.
Sean, please, for God's sake, you're driving me mad. 94,005, 94,007, 94,008. Stay where you are, because I've got your number, mate. Get me all alone in the house, train up your dogs, trap me. Shiv was right, mate. Well, I've got news for you. I'm not your lover.
Wait, Paul, give it a rest, will you? For the last time, it's the sensory deprivation, mate. You're deluded, I warned you.
You stay where you are, and you stay over your side of the cell. Oh, I've been bitten by a rat. There's a rat in here.
Paul, you haven't been bitten.
Well, how come I'm bleeding then? I'm bleeding.
Look, there's no blood.
See?
You trod on those pills, didn't you?
What pills?
The bottle of pills I knocked out of the cupboard.
What kind of pills?
I don't know. V something or other.
Valium?
Yeah, that's it. Here, Paul. Shame we ain't got no food to put them in. We could have given them to the dogs, knock them spark out.
What about a Rennie?
What? Put a Valium in a Rennie? You really have gone mad, mate. We need to smear them with something they really crave, need, love.
My blood.
I'll get the pills. Not a sign, Paul. They've gone. Right on three, we ran through the bedroom.
John, I can't do it. The dogs know. They said. They said.
You can, Paul. One, two,
three!
The legs are breaking!
I'm down! I'm down, Sean!
Like it. Roll top pedestal, bath, marble floor, dual sinks, lovely decorative cabinet. Shame it's free pro, huh? Yeah, Paul, look at this. Remagel, Alib Orange, McLean's whitening toothpaste. We're gonna have a feast, mate.
Valium. What were those pills?
Hang on, I'll tell you now. Viagra.
Viagra? What's that going to do to them?
I don't know, but I'll tell you something. Unless we get out of here a bit sharpish, your little girly, Tasmin, is going to be the one who finds out.
What are you talking about now?
Listen. Church bells, isn't it? It's Sunday, mate.
Oh, bollocks.
Come on! The cab's outside!
At last, what you been doing?
With your swimming trunks.
Well, you wasted your time because I ain't going fucking swimming. I ain't going to give him the satisfaction.
Honestly, Dad, you're going to be like this all day.
What I don't understand is why we got to go to him. Why can't he come to us? That's what we used to do in my day.
Well, you didn't have a mansion in Box Hill Town. I mean, you live with your mum till we got married. He's probably just firing up the barbecue right now.
Yeah, or taking the cover off the pool.
Locked. Why did she lock every door?
Leave it to me. We're safe, Paul.
What, from not having women's clothes? Oh, yeah, that was really getting to me, Sean.
Now, don't you see? Clothing, the mistress, smells like, yeah? Her scent, friendly, yeah?
Well, if Pudsey's to the left, why the fuck has that sign got Chapel Farm Animal Trail on the c***?
I thought you was meant to know every road, Dad.
Not round here. Carriage office don't ask you about fucking Box Hill, do they?
Excuse me, love. Couldn't tell me where Luscombe Grange is.
Never heard of it.
Well, he'd better be cooking up some fucking good steaks, I tell you. And if that fucking pervert mate of his is there, I'll fucking kill the c***.
What are you talking about?
No, she ain't told you about that, has she? About this fucking nonce mate of his, follows him everywhere.
Dad!
Animal sex he was talking about. Videos. Fucking charming, that is.
It's all right, Mum, it was the security. But don't worry, he's in Russia.
Oh, that's nice.
Fucking drive past, you stupid c***! Oh, Jesus Christ!
Himself all dolled up for you.
Come on, Sean. Tams will be here any second.
Won't be a minute.
Listen, Sean, about that business earlier, you know, in the shower, me going a bit funny.
A bit funny? You went completely off the rails, mate. All that talk about your mental strength, you cracked up at the first hurdle.
Yeah, only because I had to sit there listening to you trying to count to a million. Drive anyone mad.
And that's what made you think I'm a poof, is it?
Oh, my God.
What's the matter? Is it the shoes?
think we've fooled them, Paul.
Just keep walking, Shauna. Why are they looking at us like that?
Uh-oh. Oh. I think the Viagra's kicked him. Run!
Oh, I thought I told you two to behave yourselves.
Well, what do we do now? Thought we might have the fucking decency to come and say hello.
There's a door open there. Paul!
Fuck! Touch and wait, please! It's not what it seems!
So, where have you two scallywags been for the past few days?
Nowhere.
Yeah, just been to the country looking after my uncle's gaff. Just relaxing, basically, Tim, you know?
Relaxing? The two of you look dog-tired to me.
You got a car, Tim? No.
They're not playing with us. They are playing with us.
Easy, Paul. No one knows. Should be a full pack there.
Who's the postcard from, Tim?
Ah, Steve Metcalf.
Is he still in Montreal?
He's running a diner in Labrador.
Bottle of two dogs and change for the fruity, please, Tim.
I don't think you'll win a lot. You just paid up.
All right! So we were dressed as women with three dogs trying to shag us. But we didn't ask the old woman to join in. And we didn't know the pills was Viagra. You'd have done the same if you'd been trapped in a toilet for 3 days in total darkness, eating toothpaste. Tell him, Sean, tell him.
Ignore him, he's barking.
Who let the dogs out? The party was nice, the party was pumping. And everybody having a ball. Until the fellas started in calling. And the girls respond to the call. I have a poor one shout out. Who let